It's now time for the three-dimensional group to do their part in the task.
Our 30 different statute items, they're marked with numbers. You need to pick which one you think would be the easiest to replicate. You'll have about a minute to do so, starting now.
And they have to sculpt this?
I can't say anymore.
Probably, I'm gonna go with 22.
Which one's that? This one?
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna get a call. You're gonna get 1 minute and a half.
A minute and a half?
Yes, where Simon will be describing the sculpture to you over the phone, and then you'll have a few minutes afterwards to finish your sculpture. Okay? So when you get the phone call, time will start.
Oh, this is that kind of rose arc.
Okay, ready, set, go.
Simon!
You have a minute and a half. So, I have to describe this thing and you have to make it, and it is...
Yeah, I know. Paul, explain.
It looks kind of like an animal. Okay, it looks like an animal.
Animal? Okay, what kind?
It has four legs. It has its right, or front left leg and its rear right leg, but its front right and back left are broken off. Its tail is broken off. It has a head sticking out.
Is it a horse?
It's all deformed.
Minute left.
You can't tell what it looks like. I think it might have been a cow. It has some like remnants of udders.
So it has front left and back right?
Yes. And the other legs are broken, the tail's broken, the head is just kind of sticking up, everything's broken off of it. It has a smiley face, and it has a little nose spot, and the head's like bashed in a bunch. The whole animal is about 2.5 inches long, maybe.
Oh, that's small. Do I have to make it to scale?
30 seconds.
Yes, it has to look like it. And then it's about 1.5 inches tall. I don't know. Just make it look like this. It, just like a cow, kinda. And its head sticks up at an angle. It's not like on top of its body, it's sticking up like the top, the front edge of its body, poking out diagonally, and it just is like mashed
five,
up, has a smiley face
four,
etched into it.
Okay.
Three.
And we're
two,
done out of time.
One.
I hope you did it. Bye.
Well, I suggest we'll leave it
okay,
just like this.
Okay, fingernail marks mean it's broken, and that's the head at the crooked angle. That's the one
okay.
Nostril. There's the smiley face. This is the back right leg. This is the front left leg. This leg broken, tail broken. Front leg broken,
okay,
ears
you.
And everything broken off
it.
On the head, just like Simon said.
Okay.
Simon says.
Okay, return.
Simon says, this is hilarious, everybody! Viewers, seriously. Simon says, did you get it?
On the headboard and on this table are 30 different sculptures. And your team members have been working on recreating one of these. I'm going to show it to you, and you will have 1 minute to decide which sculpture was trying to be recreated. Okay, 1 minute.
All right.
Starting now.
Oh my effing gosh. Oh my God, are you kidding me? This is so, I get 1 minute?
Uh-huh.
You're
already at about 10.
Crap. It could definitely be, I think it's the camel. But it only has two legs. I think it's the camel.
Okay. We will soon see if you are correct. I'll piece together what you guys probably already expected. We did the same thing for both groups. One was working with paper and pen. One was working with clay.
Oh my God.
The first person was the Predict the Future group. Raise your hand. Predict the Future. They picked which pieces of art would be easiest to replicate. The next person on the phone had... The person drawing had 30 seconds, the person sculpting had a minute 30 seconds to describe this piece of art over the phone to the person who takes good directions and how to recreate that over the phone. The last person then had to guess which one was replicated. For each piece of art that is successfully matched with its original, thing it was modeled after, $10 would go into the pot. Okay, so we'll start with the drawing group. Is this the original picture that was selected?
Can we say?
Yeah.
Yeah!
Yes.
What is it?
This is a picture, so $10 goes to the pot.
But there it is.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, we lost something else. No.
Was this the correct sculpture, Michael?
No.
No. So that means $10 is not going to the pot.
Come on, I have broken legs.
How do you pick a camel with long legs and a hump out of a glob of clay? My group sucked it up. Probably kind of my fault. I don't know how good my sculpture was, but you know, oh well.
That was really interesting because I totally screwed that up. And like, I think a lot of people are gonna think that that was molish behavior. And it totally wasn't. It was just me not knowing what the heck I was doing.
Like the only person that would have been suspicious in that group would have been like, Brenna, because she guessed the wrong one, but like, I don't think she's the one.
It seems to me, based on the glob that was the sculpture created, that should have been pretty easy to discern what object it was. So I think it's Brenna. That's who I'm going to go with.
Sure. You're an idiot. Well, I'm all jacked up on Nutella. This is better than coffee. I'm down like a whole to-go box of Nutella. Where's Zeke?
I think Paul is a bastard for giving Emily that exemption. That was just bull. Because I wanted her to get her ass out of here.
Because it's my knee brace. Okay, that's why I didn't do well on the task.
Hopefully we can get a huge group of people to vote for the same person again, and I can be fast because I was so fast this time.
I don't know who to vote for!
You.
Should I vote for myself?
Do I sense Melissa?
No.
Now I'm gonna grab that clay.
I'm on a lie detector now.
Dang it, Amy!
Oh my gosh.
No, everyone down there is wanting me to like, they're like talking about like, okay, let's all vote the same person, which means like, kind of screws me. I'm a slow test taker.
Everybody voted for out people.
Last season, I had my coalition that made it all the way to the end almost, you know? And this season, it's not like that at all. And I'm kind of on my own. So, it's hard.
I've been good. I've been pretty honest because everybody called me a conniving piece of poop. And I've been good.
This game, everybody lies, everybody manipulates, you can't trust anybody. Anybody that says they're voting for somebody, you can't take their word for it. So it's a completely different game, and I trust nobody.
Question number one, is the mole male or female? Question number two, did the mole receive an exemption?
I rock. So to all of you guys who think I thought I was gonna get out first or whatever, I'm still here, bitches.
Where was the mole sitting when the task was explained?
I have no idea who the mole is. Not at all. I don't know how I'm still in this game.
4. Which group was the mole in?
All the moles are still in this, which makes me suspicious. I'm not suspicious of Megan, but Brenna's being a little weird. I really cannot wait to see who goes home next. I hope it's not Tate.
5. What was the mole's position in the task?
I really don't think that I'm going to be here after this, like, because I still have no idea. Like, I have my secret little suspicions here and there, but overall, I'm still honestly clueless.
6. Did the mole communicate on the phone?
I don't know who the mole is, and everyone's a sneaking little bitch. I just hope I get lucky and stay in.
7. Where was the mole born?
I hope everybody else votes the same way, and I vote differently. So.
8. How many siblings does the mole have?
I have no strategy. I play it all by ear.
9. Which season is the mole from?
I might shoot off. Because I'm kind of going like, I'm just gonna go for it, and if I get out, I'll be a little disappointed, but I can deal with it. And then if I don't, I'll be like, that maybe will work.
And question number 10. Who is the mole?